You know, I have to tell you, and hopefully I won't offend you with my language, but you people look so fucking cool from where I'm standing. I have to tell you. This little psilocybin might be helping my perspective a bit, but it's amazing! Each and every one of you should, at some point in your life, be in a situation where you could stand right here in front of a shitload of people. It's a damn good feeling. We're Primus. Suppose the tax man, he comes to town.
Thank you. Cuba took father away. They hastened to American shores. A mother and a son are standing in line. It's a cold day on Ellis Isle. They look to the Statue of Liberty. He works in the audio trade. Smoke from the flax is filling his lungs. He's earning minimum wage. Spending spare time down on San Pablo Ave. Once a week gets a woman for the night. Rides home, tells him what's Sparentay, Sparentay, Sparentay. The boy we have American life.
Thank you.
Yes. You know, I went over and I was watching The Dead earlier. The Dead. And I was impressed by The Dead. I have a lot of respect for those fellows from The Dead. And they have some of my good friends, Jeff Cometti and Warren Haynes, Jimmy Herring, playing with them now, and that's a fantastic thing. Mm-hmm. apple snack and pie, the apple pie. Nigga taste toothpaste made of apple, not a bit funny, but you know. Them chicks, they do satisfy. We'll be right back.
Thank you.
many years ago, in a place extremely far from here, we had a friend named Jose, but Lur called him Hoser. Now, Hoser had this Nova, I believe it was about a 65 Nova, and he'd cut the back seat out of the Nova so he could put these gigantic tires and this heavy-duty rear end in this Nova of his. It was his pride and joy. He built this thing, and we said, hey, Hoser, come on down to the studio. We need the sound of a hot rod for the beginning of a song called Jerry Was a Race Car Driver. So though Hoser's not here, and Lord knows where old Hoser is, I want you all to think about Hoser. Checkered flags, but it never did come in last. Now Jerry was a race car driver, he'd say else I'm number one. With a Bosefa sticker on his 442, he'd light him up just for fun. You know, there's a great story that goes along with this next song. But I don't want to talk too much. Don't want to spend too much time on the microphone, you see. So I'm not going to tell.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Learn a Lot. Thank you.
Mr. Crinkle. Machine them out and suckle their pounding 16 penny nails. Truckers on the interstate have been known to ride the rails. Sweat is beating on the brow. Can't keep these fellows down, 'cause these damn blue collar tweakers, they're running this here town.
Wondrous night. The stars are somewhat peaking. Some of you are somewhat peaking. You know, people ask me on a somewhat regular basis, Les, what are some of your influences? Who are some of the people that got you to get up there and do the thing that you do? And one of the biggest influences on me as a musician has been a fellow by the name of Adrian Belew. Now, being the kind, giving soul that he is, we said, hey, Adrian, you want to come on out and play a little tune or two or three or four with us for the folks at Bonnaroo? And he said, okay. So there he is, in all his glory, the Rhino King. Yeah.
song. So sit back and have a cup of joe. Watch the wheels go round, cause these stacking colored twinkers, they have always run.
Thank you.
Well, that gave me a boner.
Thank you.
me, I've had a hell of a time. It's been a wondrous experience, and if you'll have me, I'll be back again. Larry Lalonde, Tim Alexander, Travis. It was a weird thing, but I had sex in my breath. I was looking for something to see. With a bar, black leather, and my best hat. Well, it was just with me, oh, and me. Almost swamped for phone, telephone said we was coming on down to pick him up. Then he said, hey, snap at me, agree. Come along, boy. Bring a friend. His name is Harold. We'll be right back. Come on, everybody, with me.
Bonnaroo. Bonnaroo.
Come on, let's get some elk in here.
Bonnaroo.
I wouldn't say it's a beautiful sound, but it is a sound. So, party, traveling through the lake one night, I said, hey man, do you remember me? Why, of course, a little snap bad. Tell you right about now, I'm lit up like an old Christmas tree. Hey, bro, you know, I'd like to thank you once again for letting me hang with y'all across the bay. I look back that night, I get me a warm spot across my heart. I shook my hand and walked away. It's the last I seen of Harold.
Flopper and Greedy finally succumb to the ways of Harold. And in doing so, each gave just a little bit of his soul away.
What a couple of dumb shits. Thank you. we don't want to perform matter, male sway to his mighty throat. Many a fat other adamantist demise will string point blank down the cavernous barrel, this awesome howling machine. Truly a wonder of nature, the super predator. Tommy the cat had many a story to tell, but it was a rare occasion such as this that he did.
You want to lay down with me? You want to lay down by my side? You want to lay down?